out of here, Patty.
Oh, my mind. Our mind is in the mountains.
Ladies and gentlemen, Patty Lee.
And this is the handsome Andrew Chow.
Hi.
Yay. Okay, obviously.
Obviously.
Our topic today
is
comfy.
Hey! Wait, it's so long. Hey!
No, they're not here either. Hi, Miss W.
Hello.
What you got for us today?
Ah, ooh,
yeah.
And
this is for killing vampires.
Oh, yes. We need that. Thank you, Miss W.
Sorry. 1 second. Thank you. Now, that's good. We need that.
I'm sure.
Is it charged?
Is it charged? Let me see, huh?
Let's watch the VCR.
I'll work this out.
We'll figure it out.
With an area of 36,190 square kilometers and 60% of it covered by mountains, Taiwan offers a variety of natural wonders to explore. In addition to popular outdoor activities like hiking and surfing, the number of people who enjoy camping in Taiwan has been growing every year as well. As of 2021, the number of regular campers has reached over 2 million in Taiwan. And as of now, there are a whopping 1,790 camping sites all across Taiwan. However, here's a fun fact. Taiwanese people are actually more into glamping than regular camping. With glamping, you don't have to worry about bringing anything. Everything you need is already at the campsite waiting for you. That's why it's the ultimate option for lazy folks. Now, join me as we further explore the exciting world of camping. But before we do, ask yourself first, are you a camper or a glamper?
Camp was like 6 or 7 years ago,
okay.
And it was a music fest. It was pretty chill, nice. Music and with friends and everything, and we didn't have to climb any mountain.
That's a good way to get started.
Yes, and it was quite comfortable.
Ah, yeah. Who here has been camping the longest? I heard someone was born in a tent.
Born in a tent?
I was not just born in a tent. I was also made in a tent.
That is intense.
Ooh la la, ooh la la.
Ooh la la.
Greg, you're from?
So I'm from France.
Yes.
And my parents used to take me to the camping when I was a boy, a little boy. And we have a camping tradition in my family.
Oh.
As you can see on this picture is my grandfather.
Wow.
And he was among the first generation of French camper.
Really? So it's only a couple generations old, the tradition and hobby of camping?
Yes, 80 years ago.
Wow!
So it became more of a casual activity back then. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Wow.
At this time, they just got their right to have vacation and a salary. So these people, before the first time they went to camping, they never went to the sea, they never went to the mountain.
Yeah.
Okay.
This was their first travel, and so they need a way to pass the night in this place. Okay. So they use camping on the tent.
Oh, wow.
It's
wow.
Pretty surprising. Yeah, why were they allowed to go up in the mountains to chill?
At the beginning, there was no official camping in France. It was illegal.
Okay.
So at the beginning, they used to camp everywhere they went.
Uh-huh.
For example, in a farm, in a field, or on the beach by the seaside.
Yeah. Yeah.
And after that, the government start to write some laws because it was a mess in the seaside.
Wow.
There was pollution.
Right. There needed to be regulation.
Yes, it needed the regulation.
Right.
And maybe this picture was in a official camping, I think. It's a legal camping.
Oh, wow.
It looks like there's some people behind
us. Yeah, yeah, it's like a whole camping ground.
The clothes and everything.
Yeah. stay for 1 week there. Yeah. And having
this is kind of cool. It makes me feel like Taiwan is kind of going through right now what your grandparents were experiencing back then in the 50s.
I feel that Taiwan camping history has started maybe 15 years ago, 20 years ago. Okay. Actually, there were a lot of campers before. For example, the Aborigines, they used to camp.
Yep.
The Japanese, 100 years ago, they camped in Taiwan mountains. But the family camping in Taiwan, maybe no more than 20 years.
Right.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so you kept the family tradition.
I think
camping.
So.
Yeah. Who else did? Who grew up camping with the family? Mike?
Grew up maybe more camping with my brothers and more outside, off-road.
Okay.
Hiking.
Off-road.
Maybe going to the forest and making some hut with wood and everything, sleeping there.
Very so simple, cool. Very easy.
Oh, that's things. So cool.
Yeah, right. Yeah, that's a little bit.
And when the sun goes down, you chill a bit and then you go to bed early, right? And get up in the morning.
Yes, and you just go inside.
Because it's cold. Yeah.
Because maybe you're scared of sounds everywhere. Can we stay together?
Bring the girl.
I remember the first time I went camping, I was sleeping in my aunt's backyard, and even that scared me. And I was like, are there mountain lions here? Andrew, you're in the city.
You're so dark and quiet.
Yeah.
Well, what do you love most about camping?
The quietness and becoming a very natural way.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I love to, because we are staying here, there's no one around, just go being with friends. And having slowing down.
Yes, slowing down is very important.
And doing very simple things. You don't have a mobile phone.
There's no
you
reception
don't have
either.
Any reception. So forget about it and just look at small animals somewhere there. Mm-hmm. And I love that.
Enjoying the moment by the moment.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Yeah. So Mark goes the more simple way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I think you go first.
Yes, we have two city girls here. Harry and Liz.
I love your bag.
I like it.
It looks heavy duty.
But you know, it's a big contrast with what she's wearing and her hairstyle, everything. Yeah.
Her hair is done. She's got nice little leather shoes and then that monstrosity. Uh-huh.
This is not what I'm wearing in a mountain.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Tell
us about your gear.
This is actually the first backpack I have for the mountains.
Mm-hmm,
And I also the first time I go hiking myself. I went hiking myself for 4 days.
For 4 days?
So, wait.
Solo?
Yeah. Solo camping. Wait. I need to ask. Isn't solo camping a bit dangerous? Shouldn't you bring a buddy with you?
Yeah. What about the buddy system?
No. But I think it's quite dangerous if you go by yourself, but I always choose somewhere I have thing to.
Oh, okay.
Or maybe I go with my friend time and I know the routine very well and I know I can take care of myself.
Okay.
But also you need to prepare before you go and you need to download the maps. No, you need to take care of yourself.
Plan ahead.
Yes.
Prepare for any outcome.
Yes.
So this is you, solo.
Yeah, this is me. And I just just find the furries. And
this is sexy.
Thank you.
Little girls putting up a tent.
Tough.
By yourself.
Yeah, girl power.
So sexy. Where is this?
Tongho, Lingdao is across to Wulai.
没错，今天呢，我久违的再度 solo trip， 这是我自己的独自旅行。
Who's been there? Greg?
Yeah.
Greg?
Yeah.
No, Liz, no?
No.
Mark,
not yet.
Hey, you should bring everybody, including us.
Okay. She goes solo.
Okay.
She doesn't need us.
Sorry.
I still will go with someone, but sometimes
be our tour guide.
Promise we won't slow you down.
Yes. And this is your video.
Oh, this is
kind
video.
Ritual.
I make a video myself and to record what I'm doing in the nature. Oh. And you just need to do everything by yourself because you're, and there's no one there.
Right.
Originally, normally I would choose maybe popular or right. famous place, and I know there will be someone. Even I do solo, mm-hmm. yeah, I still not be alone.
Right. Yeah.
That time, in case of an emergency.
I don't know why okay. there are not, no people there. So I was really like alone in the dark.
Oh,
so
wow.
I went to the tent really early yeah. and because no, the outside is risky.
Yeah, and no one to talk to. Talk to yourself so, like happy, like yeah. very.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Are you sleepy?
Yeah,
I'm a
bit. Yeah, yeah.
Should we sleep? Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, what's the coolest thing about solo camping for you?
I think it's more like overcome your fear.
Because you have fear camping in your auntie's backyard.
Yes.
Yes, right. How do you conquer that?
She's tougher than me.
Yeah, but I feel scared actually. I feel scared every time and nervous. Mm-hmm. But when I really on the way, mm-hmm. I feel I don't feel like right. afraid of that because I know I like it and yeah. I'm doing that. And I know everything very clear, so I think it's okay.
That's pretty interesting.
Maybe we would try some solo camping.
Yeah, every now and then.
But maybe you like start easy one, not too difficult one.
Like what, solo... solo glamping?
Yeah, maybe.
Solo dinner?
Solo glamping.
Like maybe solo theater or something.
Okay.
Start in the city. Start in the city.
It's pretty Japanese.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like solo hospital, you go to a hospital.
Okay.
Solo
okay.
surgery. So that was solo camping.
Solo camping.
And you were mentioning solo glamping?
Yeah, I mean, it might be a great way to kind of get started.
The phrase glamping mm-hmm. is glamorous camping.
Right?
So it's put into one word.
Right.
I heard we have a city girl that's very familiar. Glamping, Liz. Tell us about glamping.
Yeah, like I do a lot of time glamping and camping yeah. both, but I'm not a city girl by the way. Mm-hmm. And then mm-hmm. like for glamping and camping, I feel like the big differentiation between it, like kind of like. If you go glamping, you can go with your friends and then to have a lot of fun. And then you don't need to bring a lot of things. Like they already settled down all the like the stuff, kind of like the tent
yep.
and the like barbecue ingredients they already prepared well. So you just come to enjoy them. And also to yeah, like kind yeah. of like the photo we share on the screen.
Oh,
so like we do some of the like the cuisine when we camping together
yeah.
and then like just like the photo with my friends to join the camping event together
okay.
so either you do camping or glamping can have a lot of fun
yeah
and
yeah.
the glamping will be like you can take the photo with your friends and then to mm-hmm. show people oh I do camping and then here's my campsite and
all those like lights and everything
yeah
and then the band
cuisine we made.
It's so pretty.
Pretty. You want to join?
Wait. Who doesn't agree with glamping?
Is anyone against
no.
it?
Who thinks it's kind of embarrassing? Isn't
no.
it embarrassing?
Yeah,
right? No.
Because glamping is like everyone can join.
Right,
yes.
Yeah.
But camping the elders is like, and the kids and
while
stuff.
Camping, you need to like carry like heavy stuff. Some
yeah.
people they couldn't.
Yeah.
Maybe their weak knees
yeah.
or something.
Yeah.
So I think it's good because people have more option to yeah. Close to nature.
Yes.
But I definitely like much better camping because you have to take off your you used to things to do things. You
yeah.
have to go to new things.
Yeah.
And for me, it's very interesting. For example, to take some kids with me to go camping,
yeah.
and
yeah.
like that, they learn how to cook together, how to set a fire,
right.
and everything. And it's very simple things, but they haven't done it before. How can you light a fire for
right.
the kids?
Yeah.
It's just amazing. They have
right.
just
well,
so, Mark,
cause
so
that,
much
fun. That's part of your program that you run, right?
Definitely. I'm doing some summer camp for the kids.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's a little bit like scouting. Scouting, we are
scoots.
Just backpacking and going somewhere and set the tent and everything. For me, it's a very nice way to nature education
yeah.
mm-hmm.
about
let's
about
the kids,
the nature,
the nature
right.
let the kids grow up,
yeah.
growing
yeah.
ups.
Okay, so you're getting them outdoors.
Yeah, we're outdoors,
oh,
and
nice.
We are
hands-on.
Cooking together, and maybe some kids are very picky, could be very picky, and they don't want that. But when we are just in the dark like that, with a front light and cooking together, everything getting very good because we've done it, we chopped the food and everything. And
you know, even the easiest prepared food in the wild,
in the tastes gets
like
so good.
Delicacy. Yeah,
my favorite is breakfast, a cup of coffee and some fried eggs.
Right.
That's like all I need. Oh.
Hey, who makes good coffee?
Who makes good coffee?
You
make
good coffee.
The best coffee in the world is in a camping.
Yes, I agree. Can you tell us more about that? I've never seen that.
It's a beautiful piece.
That's a kind of toy for the camper, or maybe for the glamper.
Okay.
So that's the stove.
That's a stove. And this is
a mocha coffee.
This is for coffee.
Oh my God! So you put this on.
So you pour the
top.
Coffee inside, and you boil, and the water will go through this.
Wow.
And then you will have your cup of coffee.
Wow. Is this an antique?
Yes, it's an antique.
Is this an antique?
Yes.
Wow.
I was camping in Aborigines tribe, and then I stay all the night with the Aborigine people, and they teach me their language.
Wow.
It was a funny experience.
Can you speak which language is it?
Yes, you know, in the north of Taiwan, you have the Taiyan, so you can learn the Taiyan language.
Do you still remember?
Of course, you can say, for example, hello, and they say, Lokarsu.
Lokarsu.
Lokar. Nisenti hao. Are you okay?
Oh!
There is no way.
That's pretty cool.
That's a kind of toy for the camper, or maybe for the glamper.
Okay, so
that's the stove.
That's a stove. And this is
a mocha coffee.
This is for coffee.
Oh my God! So you put this on.
So you pour the coffee inside, and you boil, and the water will go through this.
Wow!
And then you will have your cup of coffee.
Wow! Is this an antique?
Yes, it's an antique.
Is this an antique?
Yes.
Oh,
yes,
very old.
Yes.
This has been in your family for a while.
Oh yes, that's our old gear. Very old memory.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Wow. Antique heirlooms, family heirlooms.
I think that camping, for me, camping, it's not necessarily something comfortable. You have to set a fire, you have to pitch the tent, and it can be difficult. It takes some time, and it's heavy. So for me, when I go to camping, I enjoy the nature, I like to see animals and plants, but I know that the tent can take more than 1 hour to pitch, and you have a lot of gear like this.
And a sore back.
Yes.
And your feet hurt.
But the camper don't care of that. We're happy with that.
I've been camping in a storm once.
Wow.
It was like...
How was that?
It was hell.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, and I didn't have... We weren't expecting the storm to come.
Uh-huh.
We checked...
The weather apps,
and still rained, and the wind blew like crazy. Our tent was almost flying away. Other tents actually flew away. It was like, wow, okay, wow, there's a kite. It was really bad.
Oh.
But, you know, after being through the storm, you know, we laughed at it. We were like, how much the possibilities of running into a storm and having all of our good friends together.
Yeah,
I think that's the most important thing, getting to know the nature and being with your loved ones.
And then eventually the storm will pass.
Yes. And you know what I learned from that? No more glamping, Patty.
Wait, that was at a glamping?
I'm a glamping kind of person, okay?
God,
that's why I asked the question. Does anybody think glamping is embarrassing? Because, you know.
Oh, you do.
You know, sometimes we take our friends, they bring their kids. You know, it's hard for them to go really simple up in the mountains. Mm-hmm. So glamping is a really good way for a starter, right?
Yeah.
First step.
Have you guys any interesting stories about like the kind of people that you run into when you went camping? Greg, do you have one?
The expert, Greg.
There are a lot of stories in camping. For example, during heavy rain, and then I was camping in Aborigines tribe, and then I stay all the night with the Aborigine people, and they teach me their language.
Wow.
It was a funny experience.
Can you speak which language is it?
Yes, you know, in the north of Taiwan, you have the Taiyan, so you can learn the Taiyan language.
Do you still remember?
Of course, you can say, for example, hello, and they say, lo carso.
Lo carso.
Lo car. Ni sentirao. Are you okay?
Oh!
Really? There is no way.
That's pretty cool!
Do you guys get challenged? Like, you can do everything in the city. Why do you bring everything out just to be there? How do you explain, Mark?
How do I explain that?
Yeah, how can you convince them?
I convince with my being, I think, because for me it's so, I feel so comfortable to go outside. I think, I suppose, because when I was young, my mother, when I was sad mood, not in good mood, my mother just kept saying, go and walk in the nature. And every time go back, I was feeling good. Huh. So for me, it's about feeling things like that.
Oh, yeah?
And once I bring some friends, to the Samarkus giant tree over there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I just said, okay, let's go camp there. It's not far away, it's not far away. And we climbed there. And
four
maybe
or five
2 hours.
3 hours.
I start to be Mark, I start to be tired and hungry. And we find just a super place next by a giant tree. And it was fabulous. Wow. We've seen some flying squirrel things or something. And, that's they so cool. remember this long way to go, but they remember as well this fabulous night.
Mm-hmm. And I've heard you also, like, some in terms of equipment, you help people in wheelchairs even get into the mountains to go camping.
That's another human adventure. Yes,
wow.
Definitely. That's
wow!
Oh,
wow! Oh my goodness, that's
all. You have a big heart.
That's giving me goosebumps.
Wow.
That is fantastic tool that means that names Joelette. In Chinese we said Jolun, Jolai, Jolai, together doing, let's do together.
Jolai.
Have this experience since long time ago, and my dream it was to bring this tour here in Taiwan. Uh-huh. And yeah, with that we can go camping in forest with disabled people. And yeah, well, that's memory for me.
Do you remember how he expressed how he enjoyed everything?
He told, yeah, of course he said very thing, but this guy, for example, was injured, his spinal injury 5-6 years ago, mm-hmm. and he used to go mountaineering before, and for him it's like to go back to life, to go back to do normal things. Actually, it's very very simple to go in nature. Everybody can go and work and
but to have the path for everyone to be able to experience that.
Actually, it's not only about having our own legs. It's about to say, hey,
the
I
mindset.
Can do it.
It's the mindset.
Just
it's the mindset.
It.
Do you need to recruit volunteers?
Do you take volunteers? So we can accept volunteers basically.
He needs volunteers.
He needs volunteers.
We need volunteers. Definitely. Yeah, please.
Okay.
And
this is big love.
This is huge love. Oh, that's a special story. That's a special kind of story.
They have a phrase in Mandarin called a wild camping.
Oh,
right? It's like not camping in the campsites, but finding your own
little campground. You find something that's flat enough, dry enough.
That's what you're doing.
That's what Carrie is doing.
Going finding it next to the trail.
Yeah, but don't worry. I will just check the information online, and then if it belongs to government, I will check like what I need to notice. So it's actually safer.
Have you ever been camping in a very hazard kind of weather, not only storms but even higher when it starts to snow? Have you?
We are like camping like in the snow, like in Xuesan.
Oh, wow.
So it's quite a different experience.
How was that?
It's really cold.
It's really cold. Obviously,
because
it's really cold.
I think it's the 寒流急怎么讲?
It's
really cold.
So it just came out of nowhere? Did the temperature just drop on you?
We know that already, but we still need to go.
So did you, like, what kind of preparation did you Bring.
Yeah, everything. Like, I mean, I think I'd at least bring two jackets, and one is very heavy, and raincoat.
I have the same experience as well.
Yeah.
Like in cold snap, and then we go Jialuohu, one in Yilan.
Yes.
And then like the weather just like becomes so like
rainy.
Cold, and then like I felt like the temperature like below to 0 degrees.
Wow.
Zero degrees.
Oh my god. And it's pretty muddy on
the
way,
like
right?
Yeah, minus two or something.
That's so really cold. Geez.
Yeah, but like it didn't have like snowy at that time. So I really upset that why I come here so no baseball. I want to see snow.
It's
here.
Like we froze for nothing. There's no snow.
No snow, not worth it.
You French people, I'm sure you've been camping in the snow before, huh?
Have you?
Greg? In France?
In France? Greg, what about you? Have you done in Taiwan?
Actually, in Taiwan.
Really?
In Taiwan. The first time I came in Taiwan.
What mountain? What mountain?
It was in the Lalasan.
Lalasan.
Wow. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Wow. It was 15 years ago.
In Taiwan, I was going to Shishan Beifeng, snow mountain North Peak, and in the cabin over there, we were very cold. It was something. Yeah. And we were not very prepared, so we put our sleeping bag, all of our clothes.
Everything,
and so we put our feet in the bags.
In the bag.
So
cold.
Oh, just
lost.
And in the middle of the night, we just have drink coffee or hot water because we have to keep.
Talking about, even if you put everything on, you're still freezing.
Right.
You need some calories inside.
Right.
You have to keep.
Yeah.
What's your first choice?
What do you like to eat when you go camping?
Coffee, hot water, and what do you eat?
I used to do cheese, bread, and sausage. That's what I used to do. Now it's more, there's a lot of bars and gels, which are much
energized,
more very powerful.
Okay.
And you just actually could put for 2 days drinking and eating these things, and you just keep going.
Right.
It's amazing. But then after you have stomach, and I think I don't think you like this kind of
maybe
thing.
Maybe it's more difficult for me because you know I have to take my girlfriend and I have to convince her to go to camping. So
otherwise she'll fight with you. She'll get grumpy and stuff.
I need to buy some delicacies.
Wow! So that's Xiao Wulai you like a lot.
Okay.
Carrie?
I think I'm similar as I'm also Wulai.
Okay.
Wulai?
Yeah, and what you do is just like bring a chair and sit there and look the view and close your eyes and then you fell asleep. Yeah, it's really easy, but at night it's really scary because there are many birds song and then you don't know what is that.
Right.
And then maybe someone will just. No, I'm kidding.
More difficult for me because you know I have to take my girlfriend and I have to convince her to go to camping. So
otherwise she'll fight with you. She'll be getting so grumpy and stuff.
I need to buy some delicacies.
Okay, so what do you cook her?
Actually, I would make some French dishes like the Provence vegetables. You know, with tomatoes, eggplant, and with olive oil, something like that.
Breakfast.
Happy girlfriend.
Is that an oven?
Not, it's just a box.
It's a cabinet.
Just a cabinet, yes.
Okay. But Carrie, do you like cooking when you go camping?
Yeah, but I just do the simple one because
French cuisine?
No cast iron?
No, just like instant noodles with vegetable and eggs. Because I don't eat instant noodles a lot in the city, so I would choose to eat
That's clever.
But
it's healthier that way, right?
When you eat instant noodles.
A little junk food outside.
When you have instant noodles in the mountain, it's one of the best things.
Yeah. It's salty, soupy.
You can potatoes put in the fire.
Oh, this is good as well.
You wrap the potatoes and put in the dash.
Ooh. In the ash,
cover it for a few hours and after.
Okay. Typical French.
This is the army style. But what if we go glamping, Liz?
Yeah, Liz.
When I go glamping, like most of us, like we don't want to cook a lot, just want to drink a lot. My friend, they are like drunk dealers, want to drink every day, we'll go glamping. And then like for the food, we just like barbecue, and then like after barbecue, we drink more than the food. So after that, we're gonna like diarrhea.
Oh no!
What? Okay. Well, what a good example.
I also do like kind of like the fast noodles.
It's a feast.
Cheese.
Yeah, we need some.
1, 2, 3
Yeah, with my friends, most of my experience, I will do, I will be a chef in camping.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah, like but like for the glamping, yeah, I don't think I want to cook more. And my friend will like let's go drink more.
Yeah.
And, do you want to have beer or something? Uh-huh. Or cocktail?
Uh-huh. Bread.
Yeah, or rice wine. Okay, rice wine. You
oh,
sure?
Wow.
Right now, just like. Maybe the time will be like 4 p.m. and they just ask me,
they do you want drinking. To
have wine? Okay, sure. Let's go.
So you have a glamping bar up there.
Yeah. I think my friend will bring a lot. He's just like a bartender, camping bartender.
I have a friend that he's an expert in camping as well, and he's also a pastry chef. He goes up in the mountains and makes cinnamon buns, cinnamon rolls, and bakes cake, cheesecake and stuff, even cookies.
Which kind of?
What? Yeah.
Where are your pictures?
I'll call him. Where are your friends? Making pastries. Does any girls, do you make pastries up there? No?
No.
Greg, no.
Okay. No? Wow. Okay, maybe I'll just
crepe?
Have to...
Crepe? Make crepe?
Make cake?
Crepe.
Crepe.
French crepe, yes.
Oh. Happy girlfriend again.
Lucky girlfriend.
These couple of years, everybody is trying out camping or glamping or whatever, or just bringing your bags to the campsite and everything is set already. You just have to... Go cook.
Right.
Yeah,
do you guys have any? Do you guys have any like recommendations of your favorite spots to go to? Like, Liz, what's your favorite spot?
Favorite spot for glamping?
Sure.
Like once I go glamping before in Yilan. Yeah, I talk about like here's like the place named Tianyesen Nongchang, close to the mountain and the sea.
Okay.
So like Yilan in the middle of the sea and of the coast and mountain. So we just camping there, and then like the place they have the like that kind of like the like a car, just like vent there, and then
trailer.
Yeah, like we're not sleeping vent, but look like the vent. They said, "Oh, the vent there," and then there's a kitchen in the vent, and also
what do you call
a
that?
Restroom.
It's like an RV camper.
Camper. Trailer.
Like the vent.
In America, they call them trailers or campers or RVs.
Okay.
Recreational vehicle.
That's pretty fun.
Yeah.
Camping car.
Yes, camping car. Camping car is just a brand.
Right. Okay. So that's Yilan.
Yeah, one in Yilan.
Mark?
I like very much Xiao Wulai. Over there, because it's a very quiet place, and you can go in forest to see the giant trees, and there's very nice waterfall over there as well. And yeah, it's very convenient. And like as well, some places you have bamboos workshop to do.
Okay.
Ooh. And then you can do some, I love to do things with wood.
Ooh.
And over there, people are doing very well.
Craft and stuff.
We're making a hut or whatever.
Bamboo huts.
Or chopsticks or cups or things like that.
And I'd love to go camping with you.
That's
awesome. Join your kids' camp.
Sorry, only 14 years old.
Oh, but you can come. I just turned 16.
Oh no.
Xiao Wulai.
But you do any
matter. I can be the tutor.
Yeah, you're the
English tutor.
Teddy Jie. There's one more volunteer. Right. Okay. So that's Xiao Wulai you like a lot.
Okay.
Carrie.
I love it.
I think I'm similar as I'm also Wulai.
Okay.
Wulai.
Yeah, but like because they are. It's forest, and also there's a river. Some people will do fishing, and swimming there. And also people will bring their dog, and also swimming like in the river. Well, it's a safe place.
Okay.
So I think it's like more like interesting to see, and you can see the butterfly and bee. And what you do is just like bring a chair and sit there and look the view and close your eyes, and then you fell asleep.
Very relaxing.
Yeah, it's very easy, but at night it's really scary because there are many birds song, and then you don't know what is that.
Right, right.
And then maybe someone will just... No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, but that's for everybody. Right, if you can recommend an intermediate camping site.
Do you have like a harder one that you like, that you that you really enjoyed, like a solo one that you like?
Maybe Jiaruohu.
Jiaruohu.
The lake.
Okay.
Yeah, Jiaruohu.
Is that the one that you got stuck at with the rain?
It is beautiful. It's beautiful. But it's not that easy for everyone, but I think it's quite best one. Basically. So if you you want to do like 2 day, one night, it will be a nice option, and it's more like adventures, and you will go up. It's more like hiking and camping together. And then when I go there, and then I go there myself, and then when I arrive there, people were like, hey, do you want some coffee? Join me or something. And there's also a guy, and he made a latte for me up there, so it's very nice.
Actually, in Taiwan, I encountered very often this kind of things that I go somewhere and people invite me to
do it. Yeah.
So sometimes I just go, if I go by myself, I just take very, very small food.
Because you know you can do it.
Just not feed you when you get there.
Yeah, that's true.
I feel so convenient.
But hey, it's the hospitality of Taiwan.
Yeah,
it's because like camping is a human interaction too. Yes. Like you need to rely on each other when the elements are so tricky and challenging.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
it's
a solidarity when you are in the wild.
Connection with people.
You made a lot of friends and you share.
Mm-hmm. Greg, do you share?
Yes, yes. I like to cook for the new friends in the camping. I like it. Yes. Okay. Yes.
Nice. So what's the place that you would recommend for people to try?
It's very difficult to answer.
To give birth to a baby.
Too many.
There are many, many places.
To have a baby,
But I would recommend for foreign people coming to Taiwan, maybe the Yen pasture near Puli.
Okay.
Wow! There's a zip at the here, so you can actually work. You can walk.
You can wear it like a poncho.
But it's like moving like this. Cut the feeler.
Yay!
Okay.
Green mermaid.
wait. I'll see you next spring.
You're a caterpillar.
Cut the feeler. There's actually here. No. You can see.
There you go.
This and then now you work like a fashion way.
You're a cocoon.
This isn't even my final form.
I would recommend for foreign people coming to Taiwan, maybe the Yen pasture near Puli.
Okay.
It's a farm.
That's the first camp.
It's not far.
That I've been to.
Oh really? Yeah.
It's not far, so you can get there very easily. Yep. It's very big, it's beautiful, it's clean.
Yes,
and,
the toilets are very clean.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's ideal camping in Taiwan, yes.
Okay.
If you get a good first experience, you continue this activity, huh?
Yeah. Oh, man. I can't wait to go wild camping.
Wild camping.
How about tomorrow? Too soon.
It's raining tomorrow.
I want to sleep in tomorrow.
Very special tent as well.
A special tent?
Yeah, I like the tent you go in the tree.
The tea tree.
The tree.
The tree tent.
The tree tents in the... Yes, there are some tents that you can pitch in the trees, you know? It's like a big hammock.
Wow.
And if you want to camp in a wild place, maybe it can be a good choice.
Okay.
Is it suitable for Taiwan?
Of course, yes.
Yeah, really? The trees are okay.
Because Taiwan, you have forest everywhere.
Yeah.
So you just have to find some trees.
There's not like a typhoon. Then you become a kite, right?
Yes, exactly. Rocking bed. That's so nice.
Carrie, I'm sorry, but what do you have in that bag? Because it looks like you just came from the mountain.
No, I'm going this way.
Okay. Cool. Can you show us a little bit of what you have inside?
What do you bring? Move there or?
Oh, no, you can just open it there. Yeah.
So this is a chair.
That's a chair.
Yeah, this is a chair. Okay. And this is my tent and my stick.
That's your tent?
Yeah, the tent. And also this inside. I put some inside.
Let's open it.
So lightweight.
So, the tent is how
the stick for
the tent is inside.
Oh yeah. Gosh, yes. I didn't realize you had everything there. Please go
ahead. Yeah, because I'm not sure.
Home there.
Yeah, the whole house.
this is for like water. If water I go bag. To the river, you can get the clean water. If the water is dirty, then.
So this is a filter. It has a filter.
You
can drink filter. Oh wow.
Yeah, you can drink it, but always the better way is you also
boil
cook the
first.
Water.
Okay.
Yeah, boil the water.
Oh, and I see some
kosher
snacks.
Kosher
meat.
The kosher meat waits.
Kosher meat. Kosher meat. Yeah. It's important.
Take that out. Take that out. So good.
Yes, I forgot to take off.
It's okay.
And this is the wrinkle for the back. The back.
Oh.
And like when the sun and
it's
you
too
can
bright,
like
you have a hat.
Yeah. And okay. Also I put
some fashion and camping.
Medicine I will put here.
Okay,
if
like
I
your first aid.
Get hurt or something, right. It's easy to take it.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, and easy access.
Yeah. And also the.
Wow.
Also I bring some. Oh, this is. For cook.
Okay.
Like,
so gas and a
my
stove.
My gas and here.
Your pot.
Oh. Pop.
Oh, the sack. Wow. Okay. Okay.
My spoon.
Okay.
And also can be maybe
knife. Oh.
Like.
Wow. So lightweight. Yeah. So compact.
They designed it in one.
Yeah. Minimalist.
Yeah. Every single tool is multi-purpose.
This is tiny.
So tall.
Oh, that just goes on top of the stove.
Yeah, on top of this. But normally I will also bring the firefighters.
Yeah, okay.
The lighters in case if not working.
Right,
because sometimes it's very old one.
Okay, well, it still works.
If it's raining, how will it work?
What?
Raining time?
Does it work when it's raining? Does it work when it's raining?
No, you just keep away from the rain. Yeah. It's okay. But it's really old, so I need a lighter to
make light it. Okay.
Hey, but why don't you want to change a new one?
Because, like, I mean,
memory,
because like, every time if I got a new equipment, I can use that for a really long time.
Oh, this is you chilling out.
Oh, wow.
It's my camera.
That's your camera?
Yeah, I haven't. Sometimes I also will bring my camera with me, but I didn't bring today.
Oh, that's so
this
so
is very, very convenient, because
so
I have
clever.
One.
When you hear the song, then you use the lighter. But you couldn't see really
well.
Yeah,
it's an invisible flame.
Yeah,
but it's hot.
You hear that sound of the gas coming out,
right?
And then
you didn't hear that because if you didn't hear that, you couldn't make a fire. So you still need to hear that.
So you have to listen. Okay.
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
It's easy.
Pretty cool. So you cook with that. That's what you cook your instant noodles with.
Yeah, and
that's
also
what you boil
like
your
in
water
a mountain,
with.
Like if I go to maybe higher than 3,000 mountain, I also use this one to cook the food.
Okay.
But it takes a bit longer. Right.
Yeah, it takes longer.
Right, because of the pressure, right?
Yes.
You can't boil that quickly. Okay.
And,
Well, that's cool. Anything else? Nothing fancy, huh? Surprise us.
Yeah.
Oh, this is tent.
Okay,
oh, the tent.
Okay, the other one. I'm going to show you.
No worries.
my sleeping bag.
Your sleeping bag?
Yeah. I really like it because.
Oh, it's so compact.
This is from my mom, but it's a really heavy one.
Can I see it?
Yeah, you can see. The cool thing is there is a zip at the here, so you can actually walk.
Oh, you can wear it like a poncho.
Feet. But it's like moving like this, cut the feeler. You need to walk like this.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's see.
Can we try it on?
Yeah, recommendation for.
Gaston's on back. Come on, you can wear it.
Okay. Let's try it on.
Okay,
so. Okay, I would recommend you right now. Who go inside?
Me?
Go inside.
Me? Okay, sure.
Okay.
How do I do it?
No, you just go
stand
inside.
Stand in? Stand?
Yeah, you just stand here.
Okay.
Stand here. Yeah, be careful.
Oh!
And then the other side. Yeah.
I'm a mermaid!
Yay!
And then,
okay.
Green mermaid!
wait.
I'll see you next spring!
You're a caterpillar!
Caterpillar!
There's actually here.
No. You can see.
Yeah. There you go.
This and now you work like a fashion way.
You're a cocoon.
This isn't even my final form.
You're happy inside, huh?
If you want to go turret during night like that, I'm not sure.
If you are really cold, like cold, and then you want to see outside, you can just wear like this and see.
Yeah.
Okay.
To see the.
Yeah,
you're more
nice.
Interested in camping now?
Well, I guess I'm ready. Let's go.
So, guys, whether you're in Taiwan or overseas watching this episode, come to Taiwan.
Yeah.
Be a cocoon. Cancun.
Let's go camping!
Let's go camping! We'll see you next time on
Wow Taiwan!
Thank you!
Thank you! Thank you! Thank you!